A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When they heard these things, they became enraged and ground their teeth at Stephen. But filled with the Holy Spirit, he gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. "Look," he said, "I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they covered their ears and with a loud shout all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. The word of the Lord.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the dark will be heard in the light, and what you have whispered behind closed doors will be proclaimed from the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body and after that can do nothing. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies? You, yet not one of them is forgotten in God's sight. But even the hairs of your head are all counted. Do not be afraid. you are of more value than many sparrows. And I tell you, everyone who acknowledges me before others, the Son of Man also will acknowledge before the angels of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
I speak to you in the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Well, as my family and I prepare to move to Wilmington, we have slowly been getting ready over the past few weeks. We have consolidated and thrown a lot of things away. In my office, I have carefully and mindfully gone through all my books and letters and pictures. And one of those pictures was given to me by one of you who were present with me at, and with many of us at the special commemoration of Bishop Guerry at Canterbury Cathedral. It was taken, this picture, at the special service one evening while some of us were there, as he was installed into the Book of Modern Martyrs. It is a special memory. I put that in a box. We have put a lot of things in boxes to be opened at a later time, a flood of memories patiently waiting to be set free once more. Yesterday, we had a yard sale. I love a yard sale. We usually have one every 2 to 3 years to thin out our belongings. I have a special hat and everything. Alan and I have been pilfering through the garage, piling stacks of this over here and boxes of that over there. And we moved over to a shelf of boxes that have not been opened since we moved here, but simply thrown in a corner with the best intentions of opening them up at some point. Turns out it's right before we move to the next place. We finally began to open them to see and to reminisce. And when we opened those boxes, we experienced a flood of memories of times past, memories of when the children were smaller, when there was only one child, or when there were no children, just the two of us. And then some boxes of books and clothes from college, even before we were together. There was a time when we were not together. A memory after memory boxed up and put on the shelf, patiently waiting to be opened up and revisited. I then started thinking about someone else opening these boxes, someone who does not know the memories attached to the books and clothes and knickknacks and pictures that make up a life. It's just stuff, right? It's all just stuff without memory, without a life attached to it. It's all just stuff without meaning. What is a pulpit but stone and wood and brass and beautiful martyr hangings? It is something different than just those elements, because spirit is attached to it. Memory, your life mixing with God's life. The same can be said for that pew that you are sitting in, or those kneelers. Look down at those beautiful kneelers, and that pew is just wood, right? Those kneelers are just different color strings acutely arranged. But that pew is where a little girl has played hide and seek with her brother or rolled a matchbox car along the top. It is where a widow has wept and an individual has prayed very private and personal prayers of gratitude and intercession. It is where someone has grasped them tightly as they hear Howland Cathedral at a funeral. Even the creaks and the smells have meaning and purpose. They are attached to particular memories, but they are just wood and cloth without spirit and memory, without our life mixed in with God's life. Memory is a strange thing. We can forget a lot if we are not reminded, if we do not have if we do not have artifacts and tangible things attached to memory. The Eucharist is one of those tangible things that we do. The taste of the bread and the wine is a reminder of the saving work of Christ for us. The wine, which we have all refrained from for a long time, will likely bring back another flood of memories. That taste of port and silver will transport us back to what church tastes like, what forgiveness tastes like, what community tastes like, what Sunday mornings taste like. But we are always one generation away from forgetting. Unless we interact with tangible reminders, we run the risk of forgetting important things. This is why it is important to remember and commemorate anniversaries of all kinds, lest we forget. The very memory of Bishop Guerry was almost forgotten. You can read about him in the Bulletin. Many of us know the story. The very memory of Bishop Guerry was almost forgotten, swept under a rug to be dealt with later by a future generation, or perhaps even forgotten. And so we remember his story today, so we do not forget. We remember within the story of the tragic ending to his life, the very best and worst of human nature. We remember God's mercy and unconditional love and the way he forgave. We remember like our Lord from the cross, how he forgave. We remember the struggle within us and thus within the church, the body of Christ. We remember the struggle within us to do the right thing at the right time, to have that foresight. We need to be reminded. We need to remember, because those who fail to study history, what? Are doomed to repeat it. And those who do not open up old boxes stored away on a shelf every once in a while just might forget those old memories. Some good, bad, or indifferent, but all that make up a life with God mixed in. Your life with God's life. And so we open up Bishop Guerry's box today, and we remember, lest we forget, that this story matters. His story matters. And so does yours. So does your story. We can find comfort today in Jesus' words. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies? Yet not one of them is forgotten in God's sight. But even the hairs of your head are all counted. Jesus is talking to his disciples, who will face persecution and suffering for claiming him to be the Lord of their lives. He is telling them that they matter, no matter what. Each of them, they matter to God. And so do you. The good news is that God has not forgotten you. You have not been swept under the rug or stored away in a box on a shelf in a garage only to be opened at a later date. You are God's beloved and are never forgotten. You are in the very heart and mind of God. Your life is intimately mixed with God's life. And don't you forget it. Amen.
Let us offer prayers to God for the saints and martyrs of the church, saying, Lord, have mercy.
For this holy gathering, and for people of God in every place, for our bishop-elect, Ruth Woodliffe Stanley, for the Standing Committee of the Diocese of South Carolina, for Michael, our presiding bishop, and for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, for Voorhees College in Denmark, South Carolina, and the Church of Pakistan, let us pray. For all nations and their leaders, for all peoples, tribes, clans, and families, let us pray.
Lord,
for mercy, peace, and justice in the world, for all those who serve at home or overseas in the military or in mission or outreach work, for Maxwell, Drew, Legree, Kurt, Thomas, Ethan, Henry, Griffin, Peter, Dennis, Christian, Brian, Keen, Edward, Justin, Andrew, Francis, and Jake, let us pray. For all those in danger, the poor and the oppressed, travelers and prisoners, that the example of the martyrs may give them courage and help, and the help of believers give them hope, let us pray. In thanksgiving for all the blessings of this life, for the baptism of Riley Elizabeth Paquette and Augustus Eastwood Auntie Porter, let us pray. For ourselves, our families, and all those we love, for the sick, remembering Tom, Joan, Mary, Marion, Rob, Rhett, Liz, Sarah, Ruth, Debbie, Kate, Stephanie, Tom, Bratton, Kenny, Al, Steve, Ben, Chad, Carol, and Dane, let us pray. For all the faithful, departed, and all who mourn, remembering Jean Frost Walker Myers, Jean Rupert Carpenter, and Emmett Zahn. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
For the life and witness of William Alexander Guerry, Bishop, Reformer, and Martyr, let us pray.
Holy God, mighty God, immortal God, adored by martyrs and praised by the saints, receive the prayers of your holy church and grant them in accordance with your gracious will through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Please be seated. Do join us after service for some refreshment and fellowship together on this Bishop Guerry Sunday. Thank you for your presence, and I appreciate the homily. It is good, always good, to remember. Speaking of remembering, let's remember that next Sunday, Independence Day, Independence Sunday, we'll be in red, white, and blue, and celebrating Independence Day. We'll also be celebrating or observing another form of independence, and that is, it'll be Caleb's last Sunday with us. And so do plan on being present. We have a special menu that day, a special food, reception, celebration, so that we can send the Lees off in grace style. And again, we're just loaning them out for a while. It's not like we're giving them away. It's a long-term loan situation. Do be present next Sunday for that special day. We hope it's a great celebration for all the good that's happened these past few years. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Lord be with you.
And also
with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and
a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, almighty creator of heaven and earth, because you are greatly glorified in the assembly of your saints and martyrs. All your creatures praise you and your faithful servants bless you, confessing before the rulers of this world the great name of your only Son. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with Blessed Mary, the Mother of our Lord, Blessed William Alexander Guerry, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen."
Amen.
gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. The God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.